California governor special election will be held on September 14th. However, today is the deadline for the Secretary of State to announce the qualified candidates. And there was some kind of chaos just a few days ago, but today, actually, it's kind of settled down. So what happened was a conservative talk show host, Larry Elder, he announced his candidacy on July 12th. Actually, he was interviewed by Hannity on the, you know...
Fox.
But during the weekend, Larry's campaign, they heard the news that actually he's disqualified.
And Kathy told me over the weekend, my reaction is, what? How can that be possible? I thought it like a foreign-born person like Wei Fang cannot run for president of the United States. I never heard of, you know, someone born here cannot run for governor of California.
Right.
Okay,
so
continue, please.
What happened was, according to California Secretary of State Shirley Weber's office, Larry Elder did not submit qualified tax returns. So it was said that each candidate needs to submit 5 years of tax return, you know, with some requirements. And somehow Larry Elder's submission was not complete. However, Elder's campaign denied the accusation. So on Monday, Larry Elder actually sued Secretary of State of California.
Larry Elder said, so if they found a redaction issue, if they found I don't redact enough, why don't they just redact them? Why did they disqualify me on that? This never happened before. All right, so he brought Secretary of the State to the court.
Right, so in the lawsuit, Elder argued that Shirley Weber, the Secretary of State, overstepped her authority because he believed, and his lawyer believed, that the law specifically mentions requirements was for the primaries, and the recall election is a special election. So they believe it doesn't apply. And also, besides, he stated that he submitted the complete tax return documents. Elder also noted that the Secretary of State had exempted Gavin Newsom, the incumbent governor who was recalled, from the requirement, saying he was not a candidate.
Mm-hmm.
So then today, the judge, her name is Laurie Earle, agreed with Elder. She believed that the specific election code does not apply to recall election. And she said if it did, she finds that Mr. Elder substantially complied with the election code. The judge also required that the Secretary of State to include Elder's statement of qualification to be included in the voter pamphlet.
Mm-hmm. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen, recently, she questioned the merit of the tariff imposed on China by the Trump administration. Okay, this is on billions of dollars of Chinese goods, basically, $360 billion. And some of them, they were taxed 10%, some of 25%, mm-hmm. Varied. Okay, altogether, it's about $70 billion. And Yellen said they harm U.S. consumer. Okay, the logic is this. When they raise the tariff, and then the goods still coming in, and then the U.S. consumer buy them, and they have to buy a higher price. Why Yellen is looking at the tariff on China? The logic is very simple, right? Just making sure that we lower the cost of the goods coming in so the U.S. consumer can buy cheaper. That way, you can lower the inflation.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that's a bad idea, okay? And that's a bad idea, I need to tell you guys. And because I think we need to tell this to our administration, okay? Remember, what's the reason for the tariff to be there in the first place? Because of all kinds of unfair trade policy, including China's CCP's intellectual property theft, forced technology transfer, government subsidies of domestic companies, and restricting foreign access to Chinese market. Remember, guys, those issues, you cannot resolve them without the cooperation of the CCP. Chinese government, would they comply? Would they collaborate with the U.S.? They do not. So what do? Either you just ignore the matter, just keep doing this unfair trade, trading, and then have have the, you know, just a blood drain to China, to the CCP, or you do something about it. This is what President Trump did. So he imposed this tariff over this $360 billion, 10 to 25%, it varied. However, how much does that impact on inflation, folks? That ratio, the tariff compared to the consumer spending of the US is 0.06%, less than even 1% compared to this 4.2% of just on a restaurant. So it really just have a very little impact upon that. Mm-hmm. And then, but if you just lower the tariff as a Chinese American who, you know, who live in China, know how things work and come to the US, are living here, that kind of unfair trade, we are basically just keep growing CCP into a bigger monster. Okay, Trump is really have his vision to apply that tariff because that's the only way to rein in CCP. Some quick news about a sudden major rainfall in the central China around the city called the Zhengzhou. And then in the matter of 2 days, the rainfall is like, 46 centimeters. I think in the U.S., how do I understand that?
It's more about
like 12 inches, something like that, right?
Right.
And then that is happening and it caused really a big disaster. Unless you do have some footage to see there. And basically, the rainfall, the water, the flood go to the subway and effectively just inundate a major subway, the whole line.
Right.
And all the trains were just, you know, the water coming in and to the point of just drunk people there.
Yeah, the streets just turned into rivers and the underground tunnel became submerged and flood water even crept to like the second floor of some buildings. So the death toll, the official death toll was 25 by July 20th, but actually people over there just really believe the number is much higher because they don't really believe the government's number.
And here as a journalist who reported China for 20 years and also reported things in this country, and I just want you to know that the death toll, okay, any disaster in China, the death toll or the casualty usually is less than one-tenth of the actual number. Okay, less than one-tenth. Sometimes it's one-hundredth. Because, you know, it's very simple. Government own all media. Government own everything. So they are their own judge and they are their own monitor. So in order to stay stable as the ruling party, as the ruling regime, they just minimize number and there's no consequence. There's no watchdog, there's no second media, there's no third party. And media like us making phone calls, talking to real person, and we got number that way. So this is how truth can be found in China. And in this is really, really tragic, or the tragedy, right? And I saw some other video, and this is just on a train with it. The water keeps rising to the point of people just cannot breathe. Some of them just die in the water.
Right.
And because they still have cell phone, they can still, you know, shoot footage. So the whole thing is recorded. A lot of the process is recorded. And so this is some really tragedy in China.
Yeah, what we're showing you is not the worst case, actually.
Yeah, I won't say a small part of it. It's just a part of it, yeah. And it's much, much worse than that. All right, we'll just keep bringing you, you know, this is like a river, this subway we're talking about. And when, you know, think about a train, if a train is flooded that way, how bad it could become.
Yeah, so the authority tried to blame the flood on the weather. But people, you know, the news from China, out of Zhengzhou, the residents don't believe so. Because one thing is that they said that the weather meteorologist already gave warnings for previous, like in the during previous 4 to 5 years, days, but no like a plan was made to evacuate people. And also like the authorities, first of all, they said, it's like once a 100-year rainfall. Then the second day they change it to, this is a once a 1,000-year rainfall. Then in the afternoon, they change it to 5,000-year, once every 5,000-year. So people were like, 5,000 years ago, they don't have the record of the weather or the rainfalls. Yeah. So how do they know that?
Don't laugh, okay? And then they are how to say this kind of record, weather record or whatever. And the record is only less than 60 years, and they dare to say this is a once in a 5,000 year kind of disaster. So basically, it's the environment's problem, nothing to do with us.